Hi all. I've been doing a bit of work on the old Ideal engine. These are bearing caps. I'm just making some shims at the moment. I think I mentioned in my video about the bearings that I'm going to have to make much thicker shims. These are way too thin to make the sort of the hole where the bearings are going to go, if you like, make it round. So I've got to pack it out a bit, increase the height, and then they'll fit okay. So at the moment, got the old sawing rig running, the 1929 Lister A, running on TVO actually, 10-year-old TVO, got a very old can of it. Just start it on the little priming bowl there, away she goes. Lovely. So these are what I'm cutting for the shims, some brass plate. It's quite thick, it's what, 1/8 of an inch I suppose. So get the saw going. Just push the clutch lever down. And away she goes. Makes the engine work quite hard. Really glad I bought this, it's such a handy thing. I'm hoping to take this to a little rally at a railway station where the engine club are going, so if I hear back that there's space, I'll be taking this along. Nice working display. Obviously I'll tidy up the saw, get rid of the clutter off it, but you know, I think people like to see stuff actually working. Lovely old Lister. Again, I still can't believe the price I got it for. I got it very cheap. It did look in a bit of a bad way, but all it really needed was a clean. The mag timing up, away she went. Really nice. I'm not going to restore it though. This is a working engine, this one. Also, to get the clutch to work properly on this, I've increased the spring tension. Got some heavy duty cable ties, and they're great because what you can do, hook it around there, rig, that's where it went originally, pull it down a bit, a few more clicks, and you can get quite some adjustment on it. I think the copper's actually clogging the saw a bit. Powerful engine, so I'll say again, she's running on TVO, so that's why she'll smoke a bit. No vaporizer on this engine. Well, the paint's dried quite nicely today. This has had three coats of carnation red now. It's going to have at least, well, I should think three or four more. I've been doing eight coats on everything. Like the fuel tank there, it's had eight coats. It's got a few dings and dents in it, but I didn't want to use filler on those. I've seen a lot of tanks with filler on, and over the years the filler cracks and comes out if it's not done right. Having never done it before, I didn't want to attempt it. But I'm quite pleased with that. I wasn't going to do the tank strap silver. I thought that would have looked a bit silly, but I did the stand silver just to set them apart a bit. But it's really clever whoever made that. Really, really nice. I've got a range of shims here which I cut earlier, and you'll be able to see they range in thickness. Don't know how well you can see the difference there, but these are a bit thicker, the copper ones. But I tried one of these on the engine, and it looks like the brass one should be okay. Might even just have to run the file over them that way, make them very slightly thinner. Something I've done here, I'm not painting this top surface. I've smoothed that over, and I'll run some emery over that once I've finished painting. That's so that the bolts clamp tight. They don't, you know, they won't be sinking into the paint, and you risk them coming loose then. So that's why we've done that. What else have we got? Oh yes, I think I've got some other ones actually somewhere. Oh, here we are. These are going to go underneath the ends of the trolley, the opposite end of the wheels. They are the supports, and they'll sit on the ground. They're very much the style that American barrow trolleys had. American portable engines typically went on quite thin timbers, sort of decked over, with handles like that on the end. Barrow trolleys generally. I managed to find an old 1950s stretcher. Had canvas pinned to it, so I removed the pins. I used that underneath or on the inside, and probably use that as a top so I can hide those holes with the battery box. So I'm quite pleased with those. Nice timber as well, and I should be able to use some of that for the cross pieces as well. The axle's painted now, wheels and axles, and I'll trim the split pins off when we're ready to go. The welding's not great, but it's quite strong, so they should be alright. What else have we got? Oh yes, starting handle. Painted that now, that's finished. This is the little detent lever. It sort of latches into the rocker arm to hold the exhaust valve open. So I just painted the oil hole there red, and I'll do that on some of the other ones as well on the engine. Cleaned up all the fixings, so that's ready to go back on. Always remove paint from the working parts, otherwise you'll find they can bind or stick, just don't work quite as well. The cam there, finished that a while ago. This is the rocker arm for the exhaust. Seems a lot of stuff was made by a foundry by the name of Atlas. You just see it there. Now, piston, if I can do this, yeah. It was very dirty, it was full of carbon inside, so I have now cleaned it out. Try and show you, it's a lot cleaner in there. I haven't painted inside it like I did on the Amanco, but it's cleaner. I cleaned out the ring gaps as well. The piston looks good, there's a little pitting and scoring, but for such a basic engine running at such a slow speed, it'll be fine. We need new shims on the big end, there's not enough of them. Whoever, you know, did this, they made the big end bolts actually out of bolts. They shouldn't be there. They should be specifically machined for the purpose. And they didn't use enough shims, so tightening it up fully would have made it bind on the crank. So that's not very good, but easy to sort. Oh yes, now last night I had a very interesting conversation with a chap who has some brand new ones of these. Now this is not the original governor weight, it's someone's made it out of a bit of steel, and you can see just how thin it's worn at the end there. Look at that thickness there, and then what it should be, this end. He's actually got some bronze ones cast, and he said I can buy one if I like. And he's also got a brand new laser cut original fan. This is a car fan someone's used, so he should be able to put it back to pretty much its original specification. So I'm quite pleased about that. That'll you know, just finish the engine off quite nicely. I don't think there's a lot more I can tell you. I'm waiting for the bearing material to arrive. Should have come today, but it didn't, so won't be till next week now. When that does arrive though, I shall spend a bit of time actually videoing how I'm making the bearings. I'll try and show that in some detail. The thing I thought is quite amusing is that this is an ideal lathe, ideal of London, and of course the engine is an ideal as well, so I thought it was quite appropriate. Now of course the engine was made in America, the lathe in this country. And I need to clean the chuck up. I'm going to give it all a bit of a going over before I do these bearings, because I want them to be right. Now the plan originally was, you can only just see it there, but I wanted to have the Climax water pump running off the Ideal, it shows, but the pump's more suited to the Amanco, so I actually bought a Union pillar drill, little bench top hand crank pillar drill, but it's got a nice pulley on it, so it'll run really well off the engine. Should allow it to keep hitting and missing like it should for display. Yeah, so I'm just going to carry on painting things really, and next I think I'm going to sit down and rewire the ignition system, because it's not very well done. You know, it's a bit shoddy, so I'll spend a bit of time on that. Well, I've just finished rewiring the coil ignition and battery box. That's obviously a high tension cable. This goes to the contacts on the cam, and that is your ground. In fact, that goes straight from the battery, puts current through that side. Right. So there we are, got the coil pack there. That is your trembler coil. I've put ring terminals on the front, so the connections are now sort of properly done. They were just wound round it before. I didn't see the need to replace those cables, they're pretty good. So I've only replaced the battery ones, and I put a cable tie on that one so it can't be pulled through. And what you can do, bring that one out of the way. Positive goes on the brown. Not easy doing this with one hand. There you go. And they can never touch because that one's fixed.